she is one of the beauties of nature. She inspires men of heart. She looks to a better future. She is a powerful revelation. She is heroic. It is Naples. The year is 1880. The city and artistic community are bustling with excitement. What artists will be invited to attend the National Exhibition of Turin? Painters and sculptors from across Europe vie to be accepted by the distinguished vetting committee. The young sculptor, Francesco Jerace, arrives from Calabria and the Kingdom of the Two Sicilies to Naples. To the world's welcomed surprise, the young Jerace wins first prize in the National Exhibition. He now proudly signs and dates his masterpiece. Jerace goes on to sculpt Ludwig van Beethoven for the Venice International Exhibition and the monument to Gaetano Donizetti. His fame becomes so widespread, he is commissioned to sculpt the statue of King Victor Emmanuel for the facade of the Royal Palace of Naples. Not only Naples, but the entire world is amazed at the superior quality, refinement, and sophistication of Francesco Jerace's sculpture. For the Turin competition, a perfect white Carrara marble is carefully selected. Jerace picks the subject of Victa, a political allegory to a people who are the vanquished, but never tamed. Victa, the great symbol of Poland, and often the representation of all Eastern Europe, becomes Jerace's portrayal of beauty, subtle elegance, and determination. As one may easily see, he is inspired by the great Venus de Milo. The bust of Victa quickly becomes one of the most popular and iconic images of the country of Poland. For hundreds of years, Poland may have been conquered, but never vanquished. Jerace's Victa is a triumph, the talk of all Europe. She is compared to the Marianne of France. She is the great and perfect depiction of victory, equality, and freedom. She is Francesco Jerace's Victa, a triumph of liberty leading the people. The Haukohl family collection, six generations of collecting.